Christian Barillas.
And my name is JAELAN ACOSTA.
We embarked on a journey through Harlem and our school to see its struggles, its beauty, and its art. Huge influence in Harlem with artists like Billie Holiday, who was an American jazz singer and songwriter, Willie the Lion Smith, an American pianist as well as master of the stride style, and Duke Ellington, who was a pianist and band leader of jazz orchestras, all of which would perform at the legendary Harlem landmark, the Cotton Club.
But Harlem was really a place for the black middle class because New York City was such a place for factories. And that's why a lot of African Americans went to Harlem looking for these well-paid factory jobs. So I think it was a time where there was a really strong black middle class in Harlem.
If you're talking about music and you're talking about Harlem, you know, you have to obviously talk about the jazz tradition, gospel music, blues, and if you guys will, you'll learn about in school, hopefully, the Harlem Renaissance, right? Which was this rebirth of poetry and art and all sorts of artistic mediums in Harlem. And so if you're gonna talk about music in Harlem, you're really talking about African-American oral tradition. And you're talking about African Americans essentially, right? It's a highly concentrated African American population in Harlem. When I think, if you put music in Harlem in the same sentence, right, you might initially think modern day hip hop, but if you follow that lineage back, you will trace it back. You know, you'll trace it back to rhythm and blues, you'll trace it back to jazz, you'll trace it back to gospels and spirituals. It's not that these communities of people are especially bad or worse or immoral, it's that we have focused our attention on criminalizing them.
We spoke to Julius Tajuddin, who has been selling his artwork in Harlem for 5 years.
So I started in 2008, when Obama was running for president, and was doing Christmas cards and posters and calendars, and it was pretty profitable, so I continued doing it.
How do you think art has influenced Harlem?
It influences Harlem very much. You know, you go to other places in New York City and people are doing what's produced by Madison Avenue, so to speak. But Harlem likes to do its own art. So people that are out here doing work, vending, even store owners, they're doing their own type of branding and marketing, you know, with different artwork and so forth. It's known for that.
Okay, my name is God Freedom Arlo. I am a member of the 5% Nation, and 5% is the five boroughs of New York City, which is Manhattan, Brooklyn, Bronx, Queens, Staten Island. That's the 5%. And at one time, it was a total violence in New York City. Children, it was very easy to be led in the wrong direction. We had Martin Luther King got assassinated. They was gonna burn New York to the ground. We had to do a peace march. We had to stop all the riots and do the five boroughs. 69, my educator got assassinated. And the teachings of him still go on.
When we say knowledge itself, we talk about the knowledge of yourself. See, a lot of people don't realize when you talk about the knowledge itself, you're really giving praises to Allah, but you just don't know how to find it within yourself. We give it to the people so that they can see it on their body. Arm, leg, leg, arm, head. The first letter of an arm is an A, leg, an L, another L, an arm, and a head. A-L-L-A-H, Allah. So they're actually praising Allah, their creator, in the very actions that they do that are positive and righteous. So when we say Allah, we bring it to home, a true and living God, and not a mystery God. A lot of people, you know, got their worship on what they hear. Maybe their parents, their ancestors was told by their parents of a mystery God and all that. Something they never seen, something they never heard. They may feel it because of the sensations they give themselves. That's all well and good. But when you get practical and get down to it, and you go to look inside of yourself for your creator who is imprinted on you in the very limbs of your person, the only name you're going to come up with is Allah. Not Jesus, not Yaku, not Elohim, not none of the names they attribute to the creator, except the creator. And so that you could know that when an artist, as we call a creator, create a masterpiece, as a human body is, or what we call a supreme being, is he put his signature on that creation. And so did the one we got the example from, Allah the Father. You know, Jesus called on Allah the Father, arm, leg, leg, arm, head, so that it could come from within to without. Okay, but that's what I would like to give you and your viewers. Peace, and thank you for your time.
See, that's just one of the minds of the professor. I call my father Allah the professor because I am a student that was enrolled. And like I was saying, I'm just one of the scientists. There's many scientists out here.
Something where people want to go and see where these great writers were. I mean, the Harlem Renaissance is this. This when Harlem became, they call it the capital of Black America. And the Harlem Renaissance is this era of great paintings and poems and novels. And I think people today want to go there and want to see some of these places. The Renaissance also included some of the great nightclubs, like the Savoy or the Cotton Club. And ironically, there were mostly Black musicians played there, but ironically, it was a lot of Black people were prohibited from going there. It was exclusive for white people. So in the 20s, we were talking the Harlem Renaissance really from like 1919 to say like 1931, 32. It was kind of the peak of it, and then the Depression hits and people lose jobs. But that era, I think it's really made Harlem what it is, and people still go there. There's a lot of tours that take people there to see these great iconic places like the Apollo Theater, and I think it's a major part of New York.